one of my favorite people, someone I consider a kindred spirit. He values mastery, talent, and artistry, and has always emphasized the importance of celebrating others for their work and contributions of beauty in this world and their art communities. He has even invented several awards for this purpose, and as long as I've known him, well over a decade, he has stressed the importance of acknowledging and honoring our achievements to celebrate the meaning we've created for ourselves and others. Why, this is what we do. We create meaning out of our experiences, and through this endeavor, we make a life worth living. For all of these reasons, it brings me special pleasure to celebrate Robert here today for his lifetime contribution to the arts. In Robert's world, it seems there isn't much distinction between art and life. There are few who are as dedicated as this man is to feeling, eating, breathing, walking, talking, sleeping, dreaming, expressing, and experimenting with art. Like Da Vinci, art was less of a choice for Robert and more of an inheritance. Backstory. Robert was just finishing his service in the army and he was wondering about what on earth he would do next when inspiration struck in the most unusual way. He saw a pamphlet on a side table in the barracks for none other than the San Francisco Art Institute.
How would you like to sit around all day long drinking espresso coffee with your friends and talking about stuff they know absolutely nothing about? If the answer is yes, you would like to do that, perhaps you should become an artist.
You might be thinking to yourself, what is so unusual about seeing a pamphlet in the barracks? Well, these barracks were way over in Germany. How the pamphlet got there, we'll never know. But we do know that Robert applied, within weeks was accepted, and before the end of the year, he was living in San Francisco, embarking on his life as the world's most famous unknown artist. After graduation, Robert was immediately offered a position as an art professor at Berkeley, California. Robert's art and his passion for innovation brought offers for his work from all over the world. Then he moved to Canada. Many of you probably have seen Robert's work before you ever heard of him. If you ever went to the movies or saw television commercials in the 1990s, you inevitably saw at least some of the hundreds of imaginative special effects that Robert worked on when he worked for Thomas Effects in Vancouver. You probably don't know that he appeared in Mother Jones magazine and that he traveled extensively while directing and producing a couple of short films. You see, he is the world's most famous unknown artist. Here in the Comox Valley, Robert is unknown to most for his role as set designer and builder for many local theater companies, as well as a creator of parade floats. For years, he invented beautiful floats for both Music Fest and many of the local theater companies, most of which won prizes for best float. Many of these props continue to be used in the theater productions and to decorate the annual Music Fest event. If he's not working on a community project, you're likely to find Robert involved in one of the independent art shows and events, such as the Needle Show, the Jar Show, the Shoe Show, the Oak Show. In his spare time, Robert builds art carts. He loves a good derby. In the 1970s, Robert built his first art cart out of an easy chair. You might recall his vintage convertible roadster that was a gas. Did you know that his roasted chicken art cart went all the way to Burning Man? And his 2B yellow pencil is still sharp. As soon as Robert arrived in the Valley, he began contributing several murals in the community and he volunteered his time and efforts to the Comox Valley Arts Council and the Comox Valley Arts Gallery. He even donated some of his early work to the permanent collection here at CBAG. We can learn all of this, and yet he remains an international man of mystery, as enigmatic as the moon itself, driven by the intuition of creativity to experiment with brave techniques and expressive styles. This is a man in love with the world. He's a nonconformist, a social radical. He's a little fallible and a whole lot magical. This man coined the phrase carpe diem, and he's as fearless and inventive as the ancient Mycenaeans. This is a man who cannot resist touching the Camera of Arezzo and almost getting thrown out of the National Archaeological Museum in Florence. This is a man who trains goldfish to eat from his hands. who watches the sparrow build her nest so carefully that he could probably build an exact replica. This man is a creator, building whole worlds in every moment. Though he won't show it, he's behind the scenes, designing floats and sets, art carts, maquettes. He's a jeweler, he's a gem, meeting the world in that place where freedom meets potential meets manifestation. And he shares his time, his expertise, and his ideas with others freely. My daughter says
that not a day goes by in my art class where I don't remember some great piece of art advice Robert's given me.
The contribution Robert continues to make is hard to overestimate. He's as constant as the moon shines light. This man is art incarnate. We can't thank you enough for dedicating your life to art, Robert. The world is a better place for it. Congratulations.